Jan is an inspiration and a trailblazer, and has been an extraordinary mentor for so many in this community. Kind and quiet, discreet and calm, Jan has been a pioneer for the trans community for decades. Born in Ohio but raised in the suburbs of Philadelphia since the age of 2, Jan came out to his cousin, Helene. Because she was the fellow rebel, they were both the black sheep in their family. Jan's first career was in computers in the 1970s, when computers were big and bulky, but his time as a computer operator was spent by himself in a small, glass room that felt like a fishbowl. Soon afterward, he worked in the friendly field of customer service where he learned that patience is a virtue. He first worked in furniture and eventually became a designer of kitchens and bathrooms. We asked Jan to describe himself, and he said,
"A wise person said to me once, and it's very true, I am the sum total of my experience so far in life. I'd say I'm pretty open-minded, try to help where I can, and think everybody has a right to be who and what they want to be. Even the ones I don't agree with."
When Jan was a senior in high school, he became aware of his sexual attractions. While he dated men, he realized that he would prefer they just be friends. After graduating from high school, he found his community and confidence with women.
When Jan came out in the mid-70s, there were no public resources for assistance or the internet to find information. There was a community center in Philadelphia like Compass, but it was unmarked and most people were afraid to be seen coming and going. He was told to look for the yellow building on the corner of a certain intersection and go to the 5th floor. For a few weeks, he did attend a group meeting, but it soon disbanded because the center closed for lack of funding. But Jan was surrounded by friends that really helped him and supported him through the process. Today, the neighborhood where that community center once stood is festooned with rainbow flags.
There weren't many people in the public consciousness that inspired Jan as he began the process of transitioning, but he did know about Christine Jorgensen, the first widely known trans woman. Christine became a celebrity in the 1950s and was an inspiration to so many people. Coming out as trans to his family in the 1970s was very difficult.
Coming out to my family, my brother didn't talk to me for 13 years. My parents, I gave them the choice of dead daughter, live son, so they kind of picked the live son, not happily, but they went with it, and they were pretty good about it in comparison to some. My family, I really didn't give them a chance because shortly after I started my transition at the end of 78, early 79. I moved to Florida in 82. So I just came and started over again. My brother and I shared a lot of friends, and unfortunately for him, it became about him or me. So I ended up losing a lot of friends that way. So I didn't really have much to stay for. And I was in a 5-year relationship that broke up because she was definitely a lesbian who didn't like men, and it wasn't going to work. So once that broke up, I picked up and moved here.
How do you think coming out as trans helped you develop or shape you into the person that you are today?
Well, I didn't really, other than to my family and close friends, I didn't ever come out, so to speak. Of course, my wife, I had to tell her. But I didn't come out to a lot of people until after I started coming here. And what happened was, all of a sudden, there was a part of me that I had been ignoring for a long time. And suddenly, this little voice kept saying, "I exist. Hello, I'm here. You need to pay attention to me." And I started looking for a place where I could be with other people like me.
People discriminated who you are because they were maybe insecure or they didn't feel right with themselves?
I think that was a lot of my brother's issue. I don't think he ever really came to terms with that. As a matter of fact, a lot of people in my family, after talking to them years later, we reconnected, and most of them have said, we just thought it would be him. We were surprised that it was you, because my brother was very effeminate. I never showed. I was the people-pleasing child. I was the one that made things easy for everybody, so I didn't shake the boat. And I kept my stuff to myself. So, whereas my brother was a lot more vocal and a lot more visible than I was. So I listened to what everybody said and then did what I wanted to do. One of the biggest disappointments in my life was when I was about 6. I had this idea as a kid that when you hit puberty, you switch genders. So my brother, when he turned 12, was supposed to become female.
I wish how that that's
right?
How it works. Save
Wouldn't
me like $35,000.
Wouldn't that be easy? And then he turned 12, and of course, being Jewish, he became a bar mitzvah, and it was a whole big deal, and nothing happened, nothing changed. So I just remember being really disappointed about that, because if it didn't happen for him, it wasn't going to happen for me. I was never very comfortable in dresses, and when I went to school, you had to wear dresses.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't until I was in junior high that we got to wear pants to school. So I was stuck in that costume every day.
Mm-hmm.
And I never felt comfortable. But I never knew. I just figured everybody felt that way.
Jan began the transition process by talking extensively to a counselor who helped him through the process. His counselor was a hero to him, expertly guiding him through every step of the way. Jan also had challenging issues at work when he came out after being promoted.
I think the only real struggle, because again, it wasn't something we talked about, was I had just gotten a promotion at work. I was the youngest first non-college graduate to get promoted to, female, to get promoted to a management position in the company. And 3 months later, I told them that I was going to be male in a few months. So that was probably the hardest thing, was working with people every day and then looking at me like I was some kind of science project, you know, waiting for something to happen. I had some great friends there that were supportive and treated me wonderfully, and then there were other people. For instance, they made me continue to use the ladies' room, because the upper management was all male, and they didn't want to share men's room. So they made those decisions, and there were no laws to protect anybody back then. Nobody talked about it, so there was no discussion. So I was forced to continue to use the ladies' room.
One of the issues Jan faced after coming out as a trans man was being shunned by the women of his own community. Many of the gay women in his social circle didn't like to socialize with men. And once he became a man, they didn't appreciate him for who he was, even though he had been part of the community for years. He felt there was a lot of judgment aimed towards the trans community from those who should understand, and it was more hurtful. Today, Jan sees a lot more inclusion and an understanding that people don't just fit into one rigid box.
Eventually, Jan met with a doctor in Philadelphia who would be extremely helpful in his life. This plastic surgeon now has an extensive practice helping thousands transition, but Jan was his very first patient. Jan first came to Compass a few years ago after feeling like he was neglecting a part of himself. He started attending the Thursday night gender group meeting. Once he saw how big the meetings were, he volunteered to start a men's group. Jan dedicates so much of his time helping others find peace and self-respect, and sharing his pioneering life and knowledge to do so to so many people in our community. Jan and his wife raised a beautiful daughter, but they decided before she was born to not tell her about Jan's trans status. They didn't want his life to negatively impact or challenge her life, so Jan and his wife discussed it with no one, ensuring privacy for their family. But we loved the story about when they told their daughter.
When I started spending more time here, she started asking more questions about what I was doing here. And at one point asked my wife if I was her, or if she was my beard, which I didn't know what that meant. My wife didn't know what that meant. I assumed it was a new phrase, apparently it's not. But she explained it to my wife as, you know, she's covering for me and that I'm gay. And at which point my wife said to her, this is a discussion we need to have with your father. And she told me that night, we need to have a discussion with your daughter. And when I came out to her, she was great about it. The thing that bothered her the most was that other people knew before she did. And I said, well, the only people that knew before you did were the people that knew me before and my rabbi. But other than that, nobody knew because we didn't want you to find out by accident. And then she paid us the best compliment a kid can pay her parents by saying, well, I don't care that you're trans. You raised me better than that. So, we did something right.
Difficult relationship with his brother did evolve later in life.
As far as discrimination as LGBT, the worst was with my brother. We lived in the same apartment building, one floor apart, when I came out to him, and he made a point of knocking on my door and screaming loudly so that everybody knew what was going on. Apparently my neighbors cared less than he did. Nobody's behavior changed toward me. I did move. Physical violence was not off of his to-do list, so I needed to move. Emotionally, it was hard because he was more of a parent than he was a sibling, because he was a lot older than I was, and he took care of me most of the time. So it was not much different than the rejection of a parent. And unfortunately, he didn't get over it until his son came out as gay. And he said, you know, I have a choice here. I can disown my son, or I can love him for who he is. And it dawned on him that he had that choice once before in his life, and it didn't turn out so well. So luckily for his son, he responded better, and they had a very good relationship. But it also made him realize what he had done all those years ago. And he actually apologized to me at one point and said, I should have been kinder.
Jan feels that everyone must be treated by their own merits, by their hearts, and by their actions. We asked Jan what he envisioned for our generation.
But the up-and-coming generation have a lot less fear than we did. And they're a lot more willing to stand up in the street and say, this is who I am and this is how I expect to be treated. This is where I deserve to be treated. And I think you guys have paved the road for us, that the older folks that haven't come out to the community at large, to do so. I think this generation is braver than we could have ever hoped to be in being who they are and loving who they love and not being ashamed of it. We've got a lot to learn from you guys.
We were so honored to sit down and speak with Jan and learn about his life.
On behalf of Herman and I would like to thank you for coming and sharing your story with us today. We really enjoyed having you here.
Well, thank you. It was my pleasure. Hopefully it'll help somebody down the line.